Oh, you got him?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
way, eh?
Huh?
Get in your way?
No, you're fine.
Okay.
I'm trying not to get in your way. Like I am now. So is that just water?
No, it's alcohol.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we got
so alcohol solid
on it. Yeah. Because the epoxy gets thick back here. Yeah, have all that.
Okay, so now this is just partially where it needs to be.
It's right where it needs to be on the front.
Yeah, in the front, that's where it needs to be because this is like a special trailer. And we do them all at the front because it's gonna measure out. Now the back end, we push all the way to the back.
Oh, okay.
These, we have to leave a thread showing in the front because this is the front part of the trailer.
Right.
That's where all the connections go in.
Okay.
And in the back, they go all the way in. And that's how we get our measurements.
Then we gotta measure it.
Yeah.
Well, if I'm in your way, move me. I'm kind of in the way for a hobby and a profession.
So.
I can't afford a good hobby. So you just want to leave a couple threads there for the manifold stuff that bolts onto the outside.
Yeah, the manifold, we got to make this dry before we put the... This is for the manifold, but we got to put the flanges on still.
Okay.
Yes. The front, the flanges don't get glued. The backings do.
Okay.
And because they have to, because, you know, when you go in the paint room, you know, the painters sit there and they grab hold of the flange and try to move the tube to the flange. And it gets it all balanced, so they go back in and they have to redo it.
Oh, you don't want to do that.
So we can readjust it.
Get that off.
We have to do it in front. We have adjusted in front and back is already set, so we can't do it in the back, but we can all adjust in front.
Gotcha.
How much does one of those weigh? About 40 pounds?
Yeah, probably about that. They'll put the back ones on, and then they'll measure. Then they'll glue the back ones, then they'll re-measure again, and then you start them dry a little bit, and they'll start cleaning.
So basically, right now, you're basically just cleaning threads.
No, we're putting everything on right now. The threads are already clean. All we do now is put the threads, putting the blankets on, uh-huh. And putting it back, and then we'll measure. That's what certain measurement you got to have for the trailer.
Okay.
And then after that, we'll go ahead and, when you got a measurement, we'll go ahead and glue the back. Flanges, and then we'll measure again, make sure they're correct, and then we'll go ahead and start pinning them.
Okay.
We pin the collars in front. We don't pin the flanges, we pin the collars in front, and then we pin the front collars and flanges in back.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we've been waiting on them.
Yeah.
So we're already sure of what the moisture content is in them, and that they're already pressure tested.
I'm sure they are. They're brand new. They're not just this
one. Yeah. Are the flanges the same front and back?
Yeah, same width. This part right here is the part which we have to watch. And we got another flange back there that's a little bit thinner than this one.
Uh-huh.
And we got another one that's same thickness as this, but this part right here is a little thicker.
Oh, okay.
This is our standard one, I think, right here.
Yeah.
Sometimes we have to move these back here to get the right measurement. But most usually all we have to do is just move the front.
Okay.
Just depends on, you know, depends on the trailer and depends on how long the tube is.
This one is not cooperating today. Keeps me from shaking. Everybody shakes. It just tries to eliminate it.
Yeah. I used to watch the old people, you know, they had Parkinson's and you see them just, you know, shake. And I'm like,
wonder if this is correct for that. I got a buddy that's got that right now. It's scary.
My brother has that.
Oh.
But he don't have that. He don't have that shaking part yet, but he's got it today. I guess it's that. Well, you think something's going on, you're just really hitting it?
Yeah. Nothing worse.
Because they haven't got a gun before, or a tear for it. Nope. Back on about it.
It's
a beautiful day that God sent us.
Yeah. I wish you'd hurry up and warm up a notch or two.
Oh, yeah, I would have been too. I'm running ready for warm weather.
Oh.
I went to Barbados a couple of weeks ago, man. It was just nice down there. It was.
I bet.
Even when it rained, it was nice, you know. It was beautiful.
You went to get the trailer. We gotta measure the trailer first, see the length, and that's how we come measure these, and then we can't glue these down until we measure them.
Camera I own.
Galaxy?
No, it's an iPhone 11 Pro. I got a ton of cameras, and I was sitting there thinking about this morning. You know, okay, you know you're going to use the iPhone. So.
Yeah.
That's what we're using in there to get a time lapse. Yeah. I've been painting in there yesterday. I got to go retrieve the camera here in a minute.
Oh, okay.
And we did the same thing over in the paint shop. It does a darn good job. That's just an iPhone 6. Oh, so we're not really worried about destroying it. You know?
Oh, okay.
I try to destroy an iPhone 6 every week.
I got a Galaxy A7.
Yeah.
It takes beautiful pictures.
Oh, I know. They're great. It's amazing. I mean, my Nikon and my Canon, not even close.
Yeah, this thing takes beautiful pictures. But it's, they only cost about $300-something.
Yeah. Okay, so have they already measured that trailer over there, or somebody out there doing it?
We gotta go measure it. We gotta measure the trailer. Make some, about the cabinet. All right, to the front trailer that underline. Gotta make all the way to that. That's just a measurement of how long you have to see. How long you have to go back to the head of the And then when we get that, then we can come back and measure the tubes, and we can just set the tubes to where the trailer needs to be. You have to measure
each one?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're on about something like an eighth of an inch difference. Because sometimes we can't get right at the measurement, but it allows an eighth of an inch to, play.
Yeah. What time is it?
First break.
Yeah. I got a meeting at noon, and then I got to shoot a different video at 2. And
okay.
Yeah.
So this is going to go on the Western Sales website?
Yeah, we're probably going to actually try to... this one's more of a training video than the other one. We're doing the one that's just going to be a time-lapse of one of them completely through the process. I mean, through... Okay. That purple one they just built.
All right.
Well, that's this one.
Okay.
But this one we filmed the fabrication. We filmed the paint job on it the other day, and now we're doing this. But this one's a little different because the other ones have been time lapses. Okay. But this one we want to kind of make a training video out of maybe.
Okay.
And then we've been filming the, they're all painted white, who cares?
we painted a few of them a few months back. It was purple.
Really?
Yeah.
Cool.
It was the owner's request.
Yeah.
He wanted the two outside bottom two painted purple. The pen was painted purple and the rest of them were painted white.
Huh.
That's the first time we ever did that.
Just want something a little cool, huh?
Yeah, we want something that has a little different.
So we'll do a time lapse of them assembling this next week. Go back over to the paint shop for the final painting, and probably go film the install the manifolds and stuff.
Oh yeah.
But that'll be a video. It's probably gonna last about 5 minutes.
Yeah.
But we'll turn. Guy over here. This was a whoa. Get back here. This is a learning experience over here because we didn't know what we could get away with, so we filmed in real time.
Yeah.
And some of that video, we had to speed up 20,000 times to get it.
Yeah, I can imagine that.
But we've got every weld that went into this one, every drop of paint, so it's a complete video of the whole thing.
Yeah, the main thing is when we start pinning. That's the main thing. That's the thing that we...
Is that where the pin goes?
Yeah, the pin's going to go right here, and on this one, it's going to go right here between this and this.
Yeah.
And on the front, I'd say all we do is pin the collars in front. We don't pin the fenders.
Okay. Probably not going anywhere.
And we also, on the pins, we use Loctite on the pins.
Uh-huh.
When we screw them in, they're not coming back out. And plus, we pin punch them, too, on each side of the pin.
I think we're the only ones in here. Everybody else bailed for the break.
Well, if it's break time, I'm
Well, enjoy your break. I'm going
to record.
Oh, and it ain't blue yet. No. It's probably going to take it.
At the end, we got to line them up too, right in the middle of the numbers.
Okay.
One of these holes, whichever one's closest, you got to line it up. Because when they go in, they got a screw on top that we have to put in. That way, if they get pulled over, the DOT
is on top.
Yeah, they got to see all the numbers.
Okay. So when they get pulled over by the wonderful DPS
if they make it, I guess they got paperwork on them. Yeah, for sure.
Thank you. I've been today. How long does it take you to stick it through?
How long does it take you to stick it
through? 5 minutes.
Yeah. Well, sometimes it takes a little. We wait a little longer to get hardened.
Yeah.
I feel like right now it's already hardened enough.
Yeah.
But we'll wait till it's real hard and we'll start doing the ribs.
What commercial is that on? Isn't that a different commercial? It's like a cookie commercial.
I've heard it, but oh yeah.
No, I heard it too.
It's one of those multi-pop things.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, everybody that has one swears by it. It's just a double check in here.
Yeah,
huh?
We check them a bunch of times before we pin them.
Yeah.
Because once we pin them,
they ain't going nowhere. Yeah.
So right now, before the glue dries, so we can pin them, we check them again. Because they move. When we first check them, we don't line them up with the numbers. But when we glue them, we line them up with the numbers. And that little movement will make a big difference.
Cool.
Yes, sir. Now we wait for them to dry and we'll finish the willow braider. They can get painted.
we're going. Now from here, it's basically the same procedure for the old tubes.
Correct.
Okay.
It's the exact same procedure for the old tubes.
So the other one's just a breakdown is what we need to get.
Right.
Okay.
Right, right. We'll tear those down, take the flanges off, cut the flanges off, take the collars off, do a neck thread inspection. After neck thread inspection, we'll put on brand new collars and flanges.
Okay.
And do the same. Measure the same way.
Now it looked like there were some parts that have been taken off before over here that have been decked. So do you recycle some of this stuff?
Well, yeah, we put it in a recycle bin.
Oh, okay. Well, I just saw these.
Those flanges?
Yeah.
No, they were just extras that we had brought out.
Okay.
Yeah, they still get used on something else.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yeah, they're just brand new. Yeah. They're brand new.
Stuff. And they make these over at Western Valve, right?
Yes.
Cool. I just love I love factories.
Yeah, right on. I get you.
I'm a big hairy computer nerd, so preferably a computer factory.
Right on. I get you.
Yeah. This is a cool deal. I love it. This is a neat job for me.
Yeah, I enjoy it too.
I'll be doing a religious broadcasting show later today.
Okay.
That's not near as fun. You can't cuss in front of them. They take it serious.
You cannot do that. Not in front of them anyway.
Well, I got to shoot a video for computer nerds here in about an hour.
Oh, okay.
And then we'll have the religious people. And then I get to go eat Cajun food tonight.
Oh, okay. Where's that at? Los Cajun?
We're going to the other one. Oh, God. Drunken Oyster tonight.
Oh, Drunken Oyster.
Yeah, one of my buddies, the blues man, he's playing there tonight.
Okay. Right on.
Yeah, it is fun. That's a good place. It's expensive. Golly, that'll wake you up.
I heard.
That shrimp Creole, ooh, that may be the hottest dish in Amarillo. Yeah, that'll wake you up. They ain't fooling around. Sandblast them. Thank you.
Yeah.
So do these go in a specific place on the trailer?
Yeah. By the, see the way we unload them?
Uh-huh.
You got to put them back in the same spot. But like, these are brand new, so they go by the weight.
Oh,
the heaviest,
okay.
Yeah, the heaviest has to go on the bottom.
Okay.
And it, and then...
How much variation is there? 944, 946? So it's fairly close. 943. Yeah. Move over here. I think the shot would be better from that side.
Oh, when we turn this on, it part because that shit throws BB.
I'll be way over there.
Right here, this part right here don't throw none, but and like right there where you're at, it'll hit you.
Wow.
They bounce everywhere. You might feel a little something there. It won't, they don't really, but like right there, you'll be all right. But anywhere on the side, that shit hurts.
Wake you up, huh?
That's why I brought my jacket. We gotta put that, I gotta put it on because it slaps you. And we need all our safety equipment.
Well, I will stay the heck away.
Yeah, right now,
we got excellent zoom.
You want to pick up the plastic? On the front, okay?
paint, so.
Thank you.
o'clock.